in WA. Each idol will take to the stage tonight with another breathtaking performance that they have been perfecting for you at home.
But before all that, let's bring out our trio of titans from the music biz. It's your Australian Idol judges!
Into their Sunday best.
Wow.
You
your
draw.
Australian Idol judges! Hello, judges!
Good evening!
Hey!
Good evening! All right. Now, our idols always put their heart and soul into a performance, but tonight they're wearing their hearts on their sleeves with some truly special dedication.
That is right. This week's theme is heroes and tributes. Each singer has chosen a song to dedicate to someone or something meaningful in their life.
Now, it could be family, friends, or a community. Anyone who has inspired them to be here tonight. And guys, there's going to be goosebumps tonight. I can tell you. I'm so excited.
Get the tissues ready.
100%.
There'll be tears.
Now, Amy and Marsha, what is important to remember when performing a dedication to someone special?
Don't cry.
No. Yeah, I think it's a balance of feeling it and remembering who you're dedicating it to and really sitting in those emotions, but also not letting them overtake your whole performance, I think.
Yeah, which will
always
be hard.
Always singing with heart, and I'm sure they will, yeah.
Oh, absolutely. Now, Kyle, we can expect some beautiful moments tonight. Are you ready to get to know our top six on a personal level a little bit more?
To do something emotional and to have it connect, that's a different skill than just being able to execute a couple of songs. True. So I'm really looking forward. It's always another test every week. We test these guys. We couldn't be prouder of you so far. Well done, everyone.
Oh, like a proud dad. That was beautiful. Well, over the last few weeks, we have received a phenomenal 6 million votes in support of your favourite idols. In the lead up to the grand finale and in anticipation of an unprecedented volume, we are introducing a limit of 10 votes per voter.
You can vote 10 times for the same idol or spread the love and use your 10 on more than one. It's up to you. Voting is open and it closes tomorrow at 7 p.m. Australian Eastern Daylight Savings Time.
Of course, after tonight's 6 performances, one idol will score immunity from the public vote with the final judge save of the season. An absolute game changer heading into finale week.
Okay, tonight is going to be massive. Not only the amazing top 6 will be performing for your votes, but we have 2 incredible guests, the amazing Kate Miller-Heidke. And last year's winner, Royston, is back. How good is this? Shall we get into it?
Absolutely. Our first singer of the night has a very special dedication to her mum. From Broome in WA, this is Amy.
I'm so close to the grand finale. I have to deliver. There are no second chances. This week on Idol, it's Heroes and Tributes Week, and I'll be dedicating my song to my beautiful mum, Judy. My mum is from a very remote island in the Philippines called Mindoro, and so my mum met my dad. My dad was over in the Philippines building schools with a charity organisation, and she eventually wanted to come over to Australia because of love. Dad was definitely the fun parent. Mum was, oh my goodness, she was that classic, strict, like, Filipino parent. But, like, it all changed when Dad passed. I was 15 and he actually had just dropped me off at school, and I think I was one of the last people to see him. Mum lost her whole world and she had to learn all of these new skills and provide for me, provide for my sister. Okay. I'll never be able to say thank you enough. I haven't seen Mum for 3 months now, so I can't wait. I can't wait to see her.
Oh, this is
baby. Yes, I've been waiting for this moment to see her. So proud of my baby girl.
Thanks, Mom.
So the song that I'll be singing this week is I'll Be There by the Jackson 5. This song means so much to me. I think I'm going to be thinking about my mum. She's always been there for me.
With a love so strong, I'll be your strength.
Take it up there. That's the tricky part of this song for you, I think.
Yeah.
Especially because of the meaning of this song.
Absolutely.
I'm a little bit worried that emotions might take over me. And I know that one wrong note, one wrong move could cost me the competition.
With Mum Judy making the big trip from Broome tonight. She's in the lounge, proudly watching on. Judy, great to have you with us. Australia, this is Amy!
You need another hanky? I don't have any hankies. You go through a lot of hankies.
Kleenex needs to sponsor me.
Babe, that was another beautiful, sensationally amazing performance. I really thought, I was worried at the beginning, because you start nice and high, and I thought, ooh, she started high. This is going to soar. And it did. It was, sorry, nearly said a bad word. It was really fabulous.
Kyle.
Yeah, fabulous. So I've got to watch myself. Well done. Well done.
Thanks, Kyle.
I have an idea of how difficult that was, but your poise, your elegance, your voice, and your heart all came through. I mean, I cried with you. I cried for you. You're wonderful, Amy. Well done, honey. That's all I can say.
I'm basically just going to piggyback off every word Marsha just said, because it was just so elegant. You know exactly what to do with songs, and that was like Grammy worthy. That was just beautiful. Yeah.
Thank you, Amy.
Here you go, beautiful.
That was that not
the greatest thing you've ever seen on this stage. And to do that, knowing how much emotion is behind that song was just absolute perfection. A beautiful way to open the show, Amy. Stunning. Mum, a beautiful tribute to you. You started crying. I started crying. Everyone in here is crying. Was that the most amazing thing you've ever seen? Are you really proud of her?
Yes, I am, actually. Oh my God, this is, it meant a lot to me. And to be able to hear that song dedicated to me, it's like, it meant the whole world. It's not just for myself, it's for your dad as well. And thank you. Thank you.
It truly is remarkable what you just did. Mum, I hear that your daughter is quite the celebrity around Broome. You're scoring some special privileges back home. Did I hear you got a free haircut or something back home in Broome?
Yes, I have.
You got a famous daughter?
Yes, I have. It's like, free haircut. And when I mentioned about Amy's name, oh, I'm Amy's mom. Oh, would you like a free haircut then? Thank you, Amy, for sharing that a bit of limelight with you. I'm so, so proud of you. And it's not only me, it's just the whole Broome community. And you inspired the younger people around Kimberley, the Filipino-Australian community around Australia, and the family back home. They are so proud of you. Well done, Amy.
Beautiful. Amy, I truly want you to take this moment in. You are a girl from a small town of Broome, far away in the Kimberley region of WA, standing here on national TV, the biggest stage in Australia. What is going through your mind right now?
Oh, I don't think I can find the words. I'm just like so, I've been trying not to look over there because my whole family is over there. They flew from Broome last night. And I knew if I saw them sitting over there that it would absolutely break me because they're my whole heart. And this is for them as much as it is for me. Like, this is a testament to you and how you guys raised me. And I just can't say thank you enough.
Amy, congratulations on that performance. If you think that Amy deserves to be in the grand finale, you have to go and vote for her right now. Text Amy to 0457 500 700. Amy, go and give your mom a big cuddle. Everybody give it up for Amy! Wow. Well, Australia, we are at the pointy end of the competition. Every vote counts. You must get behind your favourite if you want to see them on the grand finale stage, vying for the chance to be your next Australian Idol.
Wow, what an incredible start to the show. Free haircuts and Broome taking notes right now. Well, our next idol is from the opposite side of the country to Amy. She's our country queen with a tribute to some very special people in her life. All the way from Rockhampton in central Queensland, this is Denver.
Our country singer has never won an idol before. I really want this. The song I'm singing for Heroes and Tributes Week is Girls Just Wanna Have Fun. And it's just a little tribute to the sisterhood and all the beautiful, wonderful women in my life. Priscilla and Sophie, my two high school best friends, and especially now, Amy and Ivana, the two most beautiful gals on the planet. And, you know, my sister Kenzie always gets top billing. I would not be here without her, truly. I would not.
Hi!
I'm good. I'm so glad you're going to be in the audience to watch me tonight. This is my tribute to you and all the girls.
I'm so glad I'm coming too. That was so hard not being there last week.
Yeah, I cried so much as well. Many tears, wishes.
Well, you and me both, baby girl. I love you so much. I miss you.
I love you too. You're going to be amazing.
Denver, I'm going to assume that you're going to countrify this song.
Yes.
Always assume with me.
Yeehaw!
We're just going to keep going. Put the old Denver spin on it. Country all the way.
Come on in the morning and light my fuzzy yells when you're gonna live the wrong lyrics. Yeah, I want it.
Oh, sugar. Sorry, it's the nervous energy coming out. I'm always putting pressure on myself. I could get out there and completely stuff it. So
That's a little bit nerve-wracking. I don't quite know what I'm doing yet. Is that correct? You know, I really need to work out what I'm doing. 1 in 6 chance of winning this thing, and 1 wrong move or 1 wrong note and it could make a massive difference. I'm very nervous, so I like this song like has to be amazing. It can't not. Like, there's so much pressure now to get it really, really right. We're so close. Grand final literally is like 2 seconds away. You can't stuff up now. I just got to go out there and get bigger and better every time and sing the best I've ever sung.
Denver's sister squad, including Sister Mackenzie, is cheering her on from the sidelines. Mackenzie, you ready for this one? All right, Australia, this is Denver!
Okay, so I'm going to say, first and foremost, thank you so much for representing the sisterhood.
Yeah.
You know, because it just looks so good to see a female drummer and a lady on violin. Look, you know, Denver, you're just established, you know, and by the way, I would like some of those on my set that said Masha.
Right?
How cool is that?
So cool.
Yeah, you look great, you sound great, and yeah, you're so much fun to always watch, and most importantly, I think the thing about you, Denver, is you're always yourself. Don't ever change.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Yeah, Denver, it took me like 3 years to get a guitar endorsement, okay? It's taken you like 3 months to get all this happening, so...
Yeah, this is sick.
It's wild. Look, I just... Honestly, I don't know what's happening. Like, you're from Rockhampton, right? And Amy's from Broome, and it's like... I don't know what's happening with this show, but it's like fast-tracking people to become superstars. Like, it took me so long to get as confident as you are performing right now. Like, you were having fun. Like, you've just really...
Definitely was.
...your stride. I really wish we had another, like, 3 months of this competition because you're just really owning it now. And I'm so excited for you. You own that.
Thank you.
It's a lot of fun.
Fun, right?
Look, when the lights were whooshing down, we were all buzzing, I said... This kid's like an established artist. Mm. The only thing I could say is, where's the equality? It was all just chicks. Isn't equality a big thing at the moment? Oh, it only matters. Oh, it only matters for the girls.
Well, Carl, you could have gotten up here, but you missed your chance.
You know what? I would have. But that little weird shimmy thing that you've done, that's going to work for you. That was fantastic.
Girls just want to have fun, Kyle.
Yeah. Mate, fantastic as always. I'm just so thrilled for all of you guys because you're all ready to go. You're ready to be launched into the market, and Sony Music are very happy because they've got a lot of great options this year.
Yes, they have a lot of great options.
Thank you, Kyle.
Denver! That
gang. Kyle wants to be in your girl gang.
Yeah, bitch.
Marsha and Amy want to be in the girl gang. We all want to be part of your gang. That was so much fun. How did that feel?
Oh, so fun. My main goal was, I just want everyone to have at least a little bit of a boogie. Even, the dads are like, oh, yeah, this is kind of good. And I think I did that, so woohoo.
Absolutely. That was awesome. Now, Denver, one of the longest-serving members of your squad is your sister, Mackenzie, who is in the lounge tonight. Hey, girl, hey.
Hello.
Why should Australia get behind Denver to be the next Australian Idol?
Because, what you see is truly what you get. Nothing about her is put on or fake. That is just the dag she is deep down inside. And, that's why we love her, you know? And I think she's just got such a unique sound, a unique look, a unique voice that you'd honestly be silly not to. So, yeah.
I agree. Biggest cheerleader over there. I love it. Denver, I am loving how popular you and the other idols have become. What Australia doesn't know is that after each of these shows, you guys are absolutely swamped by fans at the stage door. Check out some of this footage of these guys. You guys are like superstars. This is amazing. How does it feel when you walk out of here getting so much attention?
I still get confused. I do the whole, someone will come up to me and, can I get a photo? And I look behind me to see if, Amy Shark's behind me. I'm like, oh, yeah, sorry, I'll just get it out of the way. I can take it if you want. I get really confused, but I love it. I love meeting everyone and, yeah, a lot of people are like, wow, you're, exactly the same. I'm like, yep, yep. Still daggy on and off the camera.
I love it. Denver, you are hilarious and you are so close to possibly being in next week's grand finale. What would it mean to you to win this whole thing?
Oh, it, honestly wild. I say that about everything. I walked into auditions, I didn't think I'd even get one yes. So the fact that I'm here in the best outfit known to man,
Right? Isn't it so
I'm
cool?
I'm living for it.
You look amazing. And giving killer performances every step of the way. Congratulations on that performance, Denver. If you want Denver to perform on the grand finale, get Texting Australia. Text Denver to the number on your screen right now. Head on over to the lounge to see your sister, Denver. Everybody, give it up for Denver! Australia, with just 1 week to go until we crown the winner of Australian Idol 2024, it is more important than ever to vote and save your fave from elimination. Remember, you can only vote 10 times per voter, so choose wisely. All right, oh, so cute. Big hugs over there. Gorgeous. All right, so many more incredible moments still to come tonight. Next, it's our young dad, Dylan, with an emotional performance you cannot miss. Idol is back after the break.
Welcome back to Australian Idol. Tonight, each singer has chosen a song to honour the people who have supported them on their journey. For our next idol, he's prepared a moving tribute to the special women in his life. From the Northern Rivers of New South Wales, this is Dylan.
This week's performance is the most important of this competition. I'm so close to that finale, I just don't want to go home yet.
The nation has voted.
To have my name read out.
You are in the bottom four.
My gut just fell through the floor. Being in that bottom, it just got me thinking about everything and questioning what I'd done. So this week, I'm just all guns blazing.
Button.
Boo. This week is Heroes and Tributes Week, and I'm singing How Deep Is Your Love by the Bee Gees. Say cheese. This song is really close to my heart because it reminds me of the women in my life who are superheroes to me. Georgia, my wife, my two girls, and my mum. I couldn't think of a better song to sing for them. Mum was my number one supporter. She got me into singing and guitar and would always be there no matter what. And I think if she was here, she would be over the moon that I even auditioned for Australian Idol. So for me to be top six, she would be so proud and wouldn't stop smiling or telling people about me.
We belong, you and me.
With this song, I'm just trying to show everything that I have to offer and lay it all on the table.
Yeah, I think vocally at that point, you should probably...
Yeah, let loose.
Being in the bottom last week, I really have to nail this song.
It's kind of a reminder to not get too comfortable.
Yeah, I don't know if Australia's liking what I'm doing or if I need to just change it up a bit. You're only as good as your last performance. Looking at everyone else's, they're also stepping it up, so I just need to get better and better each week.
You got to turn it up, Dylan.
I know.
To 100.
Yeah.
There's a lot of pressure on this song at the moment. I need to connect with the song and connect with the audience and the viewers at home and let them know that this is the performance of my life and I need to get into that finale.
Dylan's proud wife is watching from the lounge. Georgia, get ready for something special. This is Dylan!
Well, I know your eyes in the morning sun. I hear you whisper in the pouring rain. And the moment that you wander far from me, I wanna feel you in my arms again. And you come to me on a summer breeze, keep me warm in your love, then you softly leave. And it's me you need to show. How deep is your love? Is your love? How deep is your love? I really need to learn. 'Cause we're living in a world of fools, breaking us down. When we all should let us be, we belong to you and me. Yeah.
Deep is your love. I really need to learn. 'Cause we're living in a world of fools, and we're breaking our sound. When we all should let us be, we belong to you and me. Then you come to me on a summer breeze, keep me warm in your love, then you softly leave, and it's me you need to show. How deep is your
Dylan, to even get through that after watching that package, like with your mom, and I just have so much respect for you and your strength, and I'm also just so impressed by you. Like, you really are looking beyond this competition, which we're at the pointy end now, and everyone should be doing that. But a lot of contestants get caught up in it, thinking this is what it's like. It's not. It's going to end. And you need to go out there and you need to start your careers. And you are so great online. You have merch happening. You have such a great fan base building. And you're just seeing past all this. And you're very clever. And if I was someone in the industry, which a lot of people are watching this now are, I'm thinking you're going to just be able to go out and tour straight away. You're going to be able to get in that studio and know what to do straight away. You're just like a sure thing, you know? And you've done that all by yourself. Like, you've showcased that to the country, and I'm just so excited for you. So congratulations.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
You know, Dylan, you chose one of the finest songs, in my humble opinion, in the world. The Bee Gees were amazing in the sense that they wrote incredibly romantic songs that every woman thought was written for me. No, hey? Do you know what I mean? So, and you
said probably were written for you.
Well,
you're in the same mirror. I wouldn't be surprised.
That was beautiful, man. Yeah, that was very, very, and it was your version of the song, which I really appreciated. Well done.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
You know what? Everyone knows you're a no-brainer. Like, for a record company, for a management, for a touring company, boom, boom, winner, winner, chicken dinner for you. What I really like is the person you are outside of the contest. Like, you losing your mum. My mum just completed her treatment today. And watching her pick up my son was beautiful. And it just makes you think, we're so lucky to be here. You've got to live your dreams, my friend. Do it for your family. You're fantastic. Don't not do it. Just do it. Sorry, crying
again. I didn't think it would be you having us crying.
Can I, Amy, have you got any tissues left? Well, she's done the whole box.
I think we all need them now.
100%, my goodness. Don't be sorry, Kyle.
Yeah. Listen, it's a great day, but you're a beautiful spirit.
Yeah.
And I don't know if people know. You're a great singer, but you're just a top guy.
Thank you. Hey, you too.
Love you, Kyle. Dylan, another incredible performance there. I can imagine that was nice to get that one off your chest, get that one out. Did it feel good?
Yeah, I'm shaking in my boots. There was a lot of emotion there and a lot more afterwards.
Yeah. I don't know if anybody ever notices this, but I do. After every single performance, Dylan does this thing where he stands on the stage and he immediately looks over lovingly and adoringly to his family. We can all tell how much your family means to you, and it's just beautiful to see. And Georgia, your gorgeous wife is over there watching you with love heart eyes. This guy is a super special man, isn't he?
Yeah. Wow, yeah. You mean the world to us, Dal. This is insane to see, and that was incredible.
Very emotional in here tonight. My goodness. I really didn't expect this. Dylan, you guys are getting a lot of attention. I was saying to Denver before, in these last weeks of the competition. Now, you went to a footy game, and I heard you got mobbed at the game.
That's an interesting word. Yeah, I was attacked. No, I wasn't actually. I was happy to get out to the Sharks and just be back living the footy dream.
Yeah. Well, Dylan, I want you to look down the barrel of that camera and tell Australia how much it would mean to you to be in the grand finale.
I would love it. I've never won a grand finale, so I've watched the Sharks win one, but I want to win one too, so please get me there.
I love it. That was perfect. Dylan, thank you for that wonderful performance. If you are a Dylan fan, pick up your phone right now and text right now. Do not delay. Text Dylan, yes, to the number on the screen. Dylan, go see your gorgeous wife, Georgia, down there in the lounge.
Thank you.
Wow. Yes, Dylan. Australia, only 3 idols from the top 6 will make it to next week's grand finale. The competition is heating up and stakes have never been higher. Remember, you have 10 votes per voter, so you can use them all on the one idol if you like, or you can spread the love across multiple singers. All right, still to come, Camel Farmer Trent, Melbourne's Ivana, and from the south coast of New South Wales, it's Isaac. Plus, we announce who gets the final judge save of the season. But after the break, we are joined by the award-winning Kate Miller-Heidke for a very special performance. I cannot wait for that. Idol will be back in just a moment. Are paying tribute to the loved ones in their lives. And here in the audience tonight are the loved ones of someone else in the Idol family. I'm talking about Scotty T's mum, Lynn, and his sister, Nicola. Lynn, we love Scott. Tell us all about your boy. What was he like growing up?
Oh, he was a beautiful boy growing up. He had a bit of prank patrol in him before he became prank patrol or on prank patrol. Lots of pranks were delivered all over the place. Yes, a gorgeous baby.
Look at him!
Yeah, very cute baby.
Well, we absolutely love him. You've done a wonderful job. It's so nice to have you guys in the audience with us tonight. Everyone give it up for Scotty's family! Now, from these very special guests to another, our next performer is one of Australia's greatest vocalists. She has even represented Australia at Eurovision, and soon you'll see her as a coach on the spectacular new season of The Voice, performing her hit single, Last Day on Earth. This is Kate Miller-Heidke.
Look around below.
Judges, what did you think of that?
Oh my God, that was so good. Yeah. I remember in 2010, right? You will not remember this, but I was in San Diego and you were playing with band Folds 5 and I hadn't even put out any music and I found you at the merch desk and I went up to you and I was like, oh, I'm trying to do music myself. And you're like, you must keep going. Wow. And it was just, you were so lovely to me.
Oh, I'm glad. I have zero recollection of that. But I'm a massive fan, so thank you so much.
Oh, as am I, obviously.
Kate, tonight's theme is actually heroes and tributes. Has there been someone in your life that's inspired you or maybe a musical mentor that gave you some great advice along the way?
Look, there's been so many people. Ben Folds was one. My singing teacher, Alison Bell, she's on speed dial. But I guess the most important figure of support in my life has been my mum. We grew up, she was a single parent and we were struggling, you know, two little kids, but my mum always took the time to encourage me. She took me to singing lessons and piano lessons and she believed in me. Yeah. And I think that made all the difference.
Absolutely. Now, we're also going to be seeing you. You've taken up a brand new red chair as a coach on The Voice. So what advice would you give to any contestants that are out there and wanting to be a singer?
Look, obviously, everyone's different. But what I'd say is there are countless amazing singers in the world. But a true artist is someone who has something to say, something that nobody else can say in quite the same way. So I'd say go away, figure out what you want to say, and then tell us that story.
Oh, absolutely. Great advice there. Well, everyone, you will see Kate on The Voice later this year. Do not miss it. One more time, everyone, the incredible Kate Miller-Heidke.
After the break, it's Ivana and Trent's turn to sing, and later we'll find out who the judges have decided to save from tonight's public vote. Don't go anywhere. Idol continues after this.
Welcome back to to Australian Idol, where it's Heroes and Tributes Week. Our next singer is dedicating his performance to his hometown of Emu Park in Queensland, who are all backing him all the way with plenty of fans in the crowd tonight. Check out the cowboy hat. Let's make some noise for our camel farmer, Trent.
I just can't believe it. I could be the next Australian Idol.
I'm just keen to get out there and let it rip.
Yeah, this week's Heroes and Tributes Week, and I'm singing Home by Michael Bublé, and yeah, it's really fitting because my hero this week is my hometown of Emu Park. Another summer day has come and gone away. Yeah, I love my community back home at Emu Park. Everyone's really close, and I know they're all behind me, and they're all proud of me, and yeah, the song goes out to them.
What are you saying? Go Team Trent. Go Team Trent.
Oh, I have a go at it.
So Trent, when you're singing Home, what are you thinking about?
A lot of emotions going through me, but yeah, I'm excited to.
Look at you, you big softy.
I know, big softy. Yeah, it's a lot of nerves going through me because, you know, back home, they're all going to be watching it now if they weren't before. And yeah, I'm not Michael Bublé, so yeah, there is a lot of pressure.
Maybe surrounded by a million people, I still feel all alone. I just want to go home.
Yeah, I'm a little bit worried, you know. Australia's loved the mobile Trent moving the stage and all that. You know, it's a mix-up now, so it's from happy smiles Trent to sort of, you know, really heartfelt Trent.
It is a moment that we haven't seen from you. Just
maybe sit
sitting.
Like that, yeah.
Just sitting.
Go home.
But not that, not the spin.
Winning Australian Idol, I can see it. It's right there, and I think Australia needs someone like me. I'm down to earth, I'm a hard worker, I wear my heart on my sleeve, and yeah, sing a bit too.
With some of the Emu Park camel crew watching on from the lounge tonight, his dad John and Uncle Greg, this is Trent.
Another summer day has come and gone away in Paris and Rome, but I want to go home. Maybe surrounded by million people, I still feel all alone. I just wanna go home. Oh, I miss you, you know. And I've been keeping all the letters that I wrote to you, each one a line or two. I'm fine, baby, how are you? Well, I've been saying them, but I know that it's just not enough. My world was holding left, and you deserve more than that. Hey, and I'm surrounded by a million people, I still feel alone, and I wanna go home. Oh, I miss you, you know. Tonight, I'm coming back home.
Young Trent.
Hey,
how are
mate?
You, buddy? How are you feeling?
Oh, I don't know. I started to cry.
I understand. Look, in the package before you sung, you said, oh, I'm no Michael Bublé. And in my mind, I was like, you're not Michael Bublé's arsehair. But you have carved out your own road. Mm. Your parents, your fans, they should be very proud. Last week, I started to see what everyone else saw. And you're not like the world's most accomplished vocalist, but you're believable, you're honest, your heart's in it, you love it, you're the real deal. You are Trent. Forget Bublé, you're Trent.
Thank you.
could make a living out of this.
Yeah,
easy.
I believe you really could make a living out of this. You know, Trent, that song really resonated with me because I've been on tour since Idol started. I've been in Melbourne doing Greece, and I came home today, and it feels pretty special. So you sang that to me, right? No. Right?
Yeah, always, Marsha.
Oh, thank you, thank you. So, you know, I want you to know I can hear that you're practicing. I can hear that you're trying to be a much better singer, and for that, boyfriend, I give you props. Well done.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Yeah, I second that, Trent. I honestly really enjoyed that. I liked still yeah. Trent. I think I can hear you getting better and better each week, and I think you did a really good job of that.
There's one week left. Like, better and better each week. There's 1 week left.
Yeah, I know, but better late than never.
Is he going to get there?
It's all about choices, right? And that was a good, solid choice because mm-hmm. we're at the pointy end. Anything can happen. Yeah. Obviously, the country loves you. There is a lot of cowboy hats in the room tonight. My nephew actually came last week and he woke up the next morning and he was like, can I go get a cowboy hat like Trent's? So now I have one. So it's... I also, that song, like what you said, Marsha, yes. it was good because it's just... It's a magical song. Anytime you're away from home, anytime I'm away, I can't listen to that when I'm on the plane because I'll just be a blubbering mess. And I almost was then. It's a really emotional night. But well done, Trent. I think that was really good.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Oh, Trent! Trent! You little ripper! Wow, that was awesome. I'm sure the people in your hometown of Emu Park will be loving that tribute. I never expected to be hearing you singing Michael Bublé on Australian Idol, but look at all of these guys. Look at everyone in their hats. This is amazing. Trent, how did that feel?
Oh, it was, really special. I think I owe them all that back home, and, I suppose they've made me who I am, and, I just want to thank you guys, and I love yous heaps.
Performance from Trent. Dad, how has the support been back home from the people of Emu Park?
They all think he's a legend and we all know he is. He's a great kid. We're so proud of him. His mum and dad, his family and friends, Rockhampton to bloody Boolaloo, they all love him.
Love it. Well, so many Trent fans in the crowd tonight. Look at them all down here in the mosh pit. Everybody's got a cowboy hat on. Trent, we are so close to crowning our Australian Idol winner. Big question, have you got what it takes to be the winner of Australian Idol?
Yeah, absolutely. I've backed myself 100% and I'm on the up, and I think I'd be a good role model for a lot of Australians. So, yeah.
Well said, buddy. All right, Trent, congratulations on that performance. To keep Trent in the running to claim the Idol crown, text his name, that is Trent, T-R-E-N-T, to the number on the screen. Trent, go and see your family in the lounge. Congratulations, that was awesome.
Thank you, thank you.
Oh, I can't believe it has all come around so quickly with just one more week until the grand finale. It has never been more important to back your favourite by voting for them. It's all down to you, Australia.
Love it.
Absolutely. Well, this week our idols had the chance to give back when they were invited to drop into the UCAN Centre for Teenagers and Young Adults with Cancer. For Ivana, it was a chance to connect with some incredible people doing it tough, and she was blown away by their strength, resilience and courage. She's dedicating her performance to them tonight. So from Melbourne, this is Ivana.
I've never wanted anything so much. I want to be your Australian Idol.
Today we're at Sony Foundation's UCAN Centre, and it really means a lot to me to be here today.
I'm Ivana, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Coming here and talking to Bella, Ed and Zach just about kind of what they've gone through, it is absolutely incredible.
About a year ago, I got diagnosed with a rare form of cancer called a desmoplastic small round cell tumour. So they gave me 14 cycles of chemo.
That's a lot probably to go through.
Feels like a lot, but then you meet like tons of people here who are like going through the same thing or worse. So like, yeah. It's all relative, you know.
It's crazy what they're going through and how strong they are and how much they're just pushing through it and still being themselves is just incredible.
I studied at Berkeley in Boston.
Oh, wow.
For music.
That's insane.
And then When I came in, I saw the shooting. I was like, well, this cannot be real. Like, this is not a hospital.
This is actually really cool. There's even a music studio here. And if they can find, like, comfort in music, like a relaxation in it, it just shows how, like, powerful it kind of is. I met some absolutely incredible and inspiring people. They're just like us. It's just they're going through so much more. And I can't even imagine what that would even be like. So I do want to dedicate my performance to them.
Hi.
How are you? This week I'm singing Diamonds by Rihanna, and it's a slow, more ballad version of it. We're like diamonds in the sky. I know my vocals really need to be on point, and I really need to be vulnerable and just show that I can really connect with the song, which is something that's really important.
You've done that huge moment where your voice kind of lifts and bringing it back to that vulnerable place. I think this is definitely a moment for you to just be still.
I haven't done that before. I've done the pop, I've done the rock. Will people like that new side of me?
We're beautiful like diamonds in the sky.
The finale is literally a week away, so I just need to give everything into this performance and just show Australia that last little piece of me.
Like diamonds in the sky.
I want to win this thing.
Fine light in the beautiful sea, I chose to be happy. You and I, we're like diamonds in the sky. You're a shooting star, I see a vision of ecstasy. When you hold me, I'm alive. We're like diamonds in the sky. I knew that we'd become one right away. Oh, right away. At first sight, I felt the energy of sun rays. I saw the light inside your eyes. Tonight, you and I, we're beautiful like diamonds in the sky. I too. Shine bright like a diamond, shine bright like a diamond,
Ivan, I just heard a word come out of Kyle's mouth. Be scared, everybody. No, he actually said, I can't believe what I just heard. That was beautiful.
Thank you, guys. Oh, my God.
It's true. You know why? Because no one covers Rihanna properly, and you blew my mind. Mm-hmm. That was
He's
incredible.
Got a soft spot for Rihanna. Yeah.
That was...
That's
probably the best thing I've seen for many years. That was sensational. I don't think you even know how good it was.
No, that was...
That was...
Thank you. Oh, my God.
I think you have everyone's attention in the country. Yeah.
Ivana, that performance had so much heart. I think because of what you've all experienced, all the friends that you've made in this show, the kids you just saw who are far less fortunate than all of us, God, may God bless them all, but you sang that with so much heart. Thank you, girlfriend.
Thank you.
Yeah. You know, Ivana, a lot of the time, you know, we talk about, you know, your voice, and we talk about like star quality and style and all these things, which you look incredible, by the way. Another thing we look at is, it's a really confronting thing. I've been a part of the Sony Foundation myself, and it's really confronting when you go into those rooms, and the way you handled yourself, you were such a bright light in that room, and you're just a natural. It felt really comfortable, and I just feel like that's such an important thing to have, is humility, and that you know, in your personalities. You're very warm, and I think the country really loves you, as well as your face-melting vocal ability.
Thank you. Well, they were absolutely... They were absolutely... It was a pleasure for me to go and see them, because they were so beautiful, and they were so positive, and it was just so inspiring, because, you know, you look at your life and then someone that's going through so much, and you just, you know, you really can't take like opportunities like this for granted. So
puts things into perspective.
Yeah,
straight
big
away
time, big
yeah.
time.
Nice work.
Thank you.
Girlfriends, that vocal, my gosh, I was gasping side stage. Ivana, an absolutely huge song and a wonderful dedication to the people at the UCAN Centre. It was so inspiring.
Yeah, they were, honestly, I'll say it again, they were absolutely incredible. They were so positive and just so, it was like they were the ray of sunshine, and it was just, it was beautiful to see, and they're so strong, and it is inspiring, yeah. Really, really inspiring.
It's a wonderful thing to be able to experience. When you're part of this show, it really puts perspective into it. Now, we have some VIP guests from the UCAN Centre joining us tonight to watch you perform. A big shout-out. Hi, guys. And hello to everyone else watching from home. Ivana, you are so close to making it to the end of Australian Idol. What would you like to say to Australia, who are voting for the winner of Australian Idol 2024?
Look, I've loved this whole experience. It has been an absolute dream, and to meet so many incredible people, make so many connections, and, you know, I don't want it to be over, and I absolutely love this more than anything, so, yeah.
We love you. You are a ray of sunshine. If you want to see Ivana on the stage vying for the Idol title, you have to vote for her. Text Ivana to 0457 500 700, and remember, this week, each voter only has 10 votes to use. Give it up for Ivana!
Thank you!
All right, still to come, Isaac, our idol from the south coast of New South Wales, will take to the stage. Then the judges will decide who gets tonight's all-important judge save. And last year's winner, Royston, performs. We cannot wait for that. Idol will be back in a moment.
Are digging deep with tributes to the loved ones in their life. It's like a big warm hug in here, isn't it, Kyle?
Yeah.
Hey?
Yeah.
Hey?
Oh, you want a hug? Oh.
Come on, big boy. Come on, stand up. Come on, don't be lazy. Yeah!
That's nice.
I love it. Now, our next idol is dedicating his song to his late Nana, who championed him his whole life. This is Isaac.
I've never believed in myself, really. Don't have much self-confidence. But it's growing now, you know. I can see that people like what I do.
It's almost like imposter syndrome, always thinking, oh, maybe I'm not good enough, but you are absolutely good enough, man.
Thank you, Carl. Top six now. It's my final chance to get to the finale, and I'm just crossing my fingers I get there. This week, it's Heroes and Tributes week, and I'm keen to get into it.
Poppy.
How are you, mate?
So, the song I'm singing... Next performance is dedicated to Nan.
Is it?
Yeah.
Mate, you'd be so proud of you.
Yeah.
Mate, you go and do the best you can.
Yeah, definitely. I'm going to do it for Nan.
I mean, Nan's my hero because she's always been here for me. She passed away last year. She was always the go-to person for everything. She was the best.
Yes, she is.
Yeah, my Nan's always supported my singing. She always told me to just keep chasing my dream and, yeah. And look at me now, top six. Yeah, I miss my nan a lot. I really do wish she was here. But she's here, in spirit.
Hello.
Hey, how you going?
Good, good.
Yeah. I'm singing A Little Bit of Love by Tom Grennan.
I've been holding on to pieces, swimming in the deep end.
When I sing A Little Bit of Love, it just reminds me of Nan. I can like feel Nan when I sing it.
Need a little love.
I just feel the song in my heart.
For this first chorus, let's just keep it.
Yeah, 70%.
60-70%. Yeah. Just so there's somewhere to go, and then you can go for it at the very end. All the while, let's think about what the song means to you.
So I've got to bring a more dynamic performance this week. And I've got to bring the emotion.
A little bit of love.
And the confidence. There's so much on the line this week. Nan always said I'd get somewhere with my singing. And I'm this close to being the next Australian Idol.
In honour of Isaac's Nan, we have Pop here tonight cheering Isaac on. Good to have you here, mates. Australia, this is Isaac!
I've been holding on to pieces, swimming in the deep end, trying to find my way back to you, cause I need a little bit of love. A little bit of love, a little bit of love. Lately I've been counting stars, and I'm sorry that I broke your heart. It's something that I didn't want for you, but I'm stepping on broken glass. And I know this is my final chance. All I'm trying to do is find my path to you. Cause I got voices in my head and there's a depth inside. I got voices in my head and I can lie. I've been holding on to pieces, swimming in the deep end, trying to find my way back to you. Cause I need a little bit of love.
Man, just when I thought I couldn't get even more emotional, yeah. Dude, I'm such a nanny's girl, and I really just, I have the same thing with my nan who's getting on now, but just that person who's always consistently there, you know, whenever I was in shit, whether it was like financially, mentally, emotionally, just, you know, someone who's always there, that's what they're good for. And I thought, usually we wait for you to hit the sort of the middle of the song to really hit your peak. You just hit it straight up then. Yeah. You are like really hitting your stride. That was awesome, man.
You know, I just love that performance because it was dynamic. You had confidence and you had heart. And that's what it's about when you sing.
Thank you, Martha.
Yeah, man. Yeah.
That was real good, man. That was, I think the last couple of weeks, you've really found your feet. You're more comfortable. Mm. You know what you're doing. You feel like you belong. And I just wish you would have got here quicker because you're fantastic to watch, man. Great voice.
Thank you, Kyle.
There's a lot of love in this room for you, Isaac. I've got to say, that crowd just went off at the end of your performance. Huge track, Isaac. Speaking of Tom Grennan, he actually reached out to you to wish you good luck on socials, right?
I was seeing a FaceTime before, not a FaceTime, like a video he sent me.
Yeah.
And yeah, he just was wishing me luck, and I was like, wow.
Isaac, it was a very special tribute to your late nan. Brian, her husband, is in the lounge. Brian, if your wife Susan was here tonight, what would she make of that performance?
Well, I think she'd say, what a great young man that's trying to do something with his life, and the same as all these other contestants. And I don't know how they do it. It must be very, very hard to get up there and week after week to try and do their best. But I know she'd be looking down from somewhere and saying, thank you very much, son.
Yeah.
Love you, Pop.
Way too emotional in here tonight. Thank you. And you must be so proud too. Well done, Isaac. Everyone's hometowns have been getting behind them. And for you, Isaac, You've even had one of the local bakeries name one of their menu items after you. Check this out. Nice. The Isaacini Slice from Arcee's Bakery in Ulla Dulla. Is this a first for you? Look at that.
That's definitely a first.
Definitely a first. I love it.
Lucky
love
I like zucchini.
Yes, yeah. Yes. What about you, judges? Do you like a zucchini slice?
I'll try it.
I prefer a vanilla slice, but I'd give a zucchini slice a go.
Oh, I think we have some over here. Is there some way we can get that down?
Oh, my God, really?
Chuck it. Oh, Dylan to the rescue. I love it.
Such a wholesome night.
Oh, my Lord. A spork and everything.
Okay. Kyle, you're going to give the eyes
three forks
a go. Beautiful.
One fork,
oh,
one
love
fork.
This. Oh, have you tasted it?
You guys tested
it. You haven't? Okay.
Have you tasted it?
He hasn't tasted it.
Of course he hasn't. He's been here. Okay, let's have a look.
Save some for others, Kyle.
It smells very nice.
Listen, no fat jokes here, Ricky. You don't want me to start.
If he starts acting even stranger than what he usually does, I'm going to know what's in that.
Yeah.
Oh,
how
that's
is
really
it?
Good. That's lovely. Where's this joint? What's the name of the shop?
Ulla Dulla.
Foxy's Bakery. Love it. Thumbs up, judges.
A big thumbs up. That's fantastic.
Very nice.
Love it. All right. Well, Isaac, well done tonight. And if you want Isaac in the grand finale, vote for him. Text Isaac to the number on your screen right now. Isaac, go check on Pop in the Lounge. Okay. Who are you backing as the winner of Australian Idol 2024? We have six left in the competition, but only three will make it to next week's grand finale stage. So make sure you save your fave with your vote. Well, Isaac, it was our final Idol singing it for your votes tonight, and that means it's over to the judges to decide who will score the last judge save of the season and avoid the public vote. While our judges mull that huge decision over and finish that Isaacini slice, after the break, last year's winner Royston will return to the stage for a performance with your top six. We'll be back in just a moment.
Australian Idol. Your top six have performed and the judges are now deciding who should score their final judge save of the season. But while they do that, last year's winner is back on the Idol stage to perform his brand new single, Dreaming Australia, with your top six. This is
to see you back on the stage and with our top six. That was amazing. I know you wrote that song. I love that song. Congratulations. How does it feel for you to be back up on this stage?
Oh, it feels so surreal, honestly. I'm like so grateful I get to come back and do this. Yeah, this is just a magical stage and this is a surreal night, honestly.
Yes. Royston, it has been a huge year for you since winning Australian Idol. You have performed countless times, dropped music. You've been to LA to work with writers and producers. You performed to thousands at the Opera House. Just an incredible year for you. I hear you've been writing some new music. What is on the horizon for you?
So I might be having an EP coming out soon. Okay. Well, I definitely am. You know, I'm not like, it's just been a creative, like, process. Like, I've been really trying to dig deep, you know, and I'm just so grateful I get to do this and tell my stories through music. And yeah, I got to go to LA and work with some incredible people. Yep. So I'm just excited for you guys to hear some more music. I hope you guys are keen.
Yeah, can't wait to hear your new music. If that song's anything to go by, chef's kiss. So great to see you again, Royston. You can download or stream Dreaming right now. Give it up for Royston.
Thank you, guys.
All right. Well, it is business time and our judges are making the most important decision of the competition to date. Which idol will they give their judge save to and send straight to grand finale week, sidestepping the agonizing public vote? So who's going to get it? Find out right here in just a few moments.
You decide the winner of Australian Idol 2024.
They'll earn the winning title, joining the ranks of Idol legends before them, score a recording contract with Sony Music Entertainment Australia, and win an epic $100,000 to supercharge their music career.
It is a life-changing prize, Scotty, and we are just 1 week away from announcing who wins it.
Well, we've had an incredible show of spectacular performances from our idols, but now it's crunch time. Who will get the judge save? At this late stage, the implications are huge, so I can only imagine the decision was tougher than usual. Kyle and Marsha, all six, they've got the star power to be standing on the grand finale stage, but only three will get there, and then only one will become the Australian Idol. It really could be anyone's to win, right?
We have no idea, you know, and I mean, like, everybody's so strong. You guys have all stepped up, and all I can say on my part is I congratulate you all. We have no idea what's going to happen.
We can see everyone on stage with their own album, their own career, their own success. So it is up to Australia really to decide, mm-hmm. I feel.
All right. Well, Amy, it is decision time. Who have you and your fellow judges chosen to save from the public vote and send into the grand finale?
Well, like these guys said, it was a pretty massive night. A very
huge,
emotional night.
Yes.
A scary night. But the idol that we have decided to save idol we're going to save tonight is actually nobody.
We're saving no one.
It's up to Australia
now. No judge save.
We think it's fairer because all these guys are great. We think it's much fairer if the public decide who their Australian idol is.
Wow.
And that gives you guys some more time to hang out too, right?
Wow.
So that's the upside of it.
Okay.
Yeah. But now, you know, if you guys, we keep reiterating this, you got to vote.
Mm. Yes.
If you like these guys, you got to vote for who you really dig. And we're leaving this and putting this in Australia's hands. Please vote.
Because the last vote Australia did went so well.
Yeah.
Ah, we all turned.
Oh my gosh.
But really, like any one of the, it's up to you guys now to vote. All of them. We've done our job.
Yep.
It's up to you. Which one do you want? Someone's going to win. Have a think. Go back. Watch the tapes. They're all fantastic.
Vote for your favourites. Okay, well, Australia, the power is in your hands.
Certainly is.
With no judge save, all of our top six need your votes. So get behind your favourites.
Here's a reminder of all the amazing performances tonight.
Run, baby, I'm done.
Oh, yeah. Nevada!